Yeah, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can install Kali Linux in VirtualBox in Windows machine. So let's start the video. So in order to install Kali Linux in VirtualBox, first of all, we need to install the VirtualBox. For that, we'll go to the official website of VirtualBox, virtualbox.org, and go to the download section. Here you have to choose your machine, on which machine you want to install the VirtualBox. So currently I am using a Windows machine, so I'll click on Windows host. And here you have to also install the VirtualBox extension pack. So click on the and download, and the VirtualBox extension pack will start installing. So you also have to download the Kali Linux machine or Kali Linux installer image. For that, visit Kali Linux official website kali.org, get Kali. So here click on installer image, go down and click here and download the latest Kali Linux image, which is 2024.4. Click on it. So as you can see, I successfully downloaded the VirtualBox, the Oracle VirtualBox extension pack, and the Kali Linux installer image. Now click on the VirtualBox and click on open. We have to install the VirtualBox. It will pop up a screen like this. You have to click on next. Then click on I accept the terms. Then hit next. Now don't make any changes here, click on next. Now click on yes. And here you can remain all the checkbox as it is. I'll uncheck this one because I don't want a shortcut on quick launch bar. So I'll uncheck this one and hit on next. Now click on install and it will start installing VirtualBox. As you can see, I successfully installed VirtualBox. Now I'll click on finish and it will launch the VirtualBox. So it will come with some interface like this. Now we have to also install the VirtualBox extension pack. So right click on it and hit on open. Click on install. So we successfully installed the VirtualBox and the extension pack. Now we need to create our Kali Linux virtual machine in it. For that, click on new. And you can name your VirtualBox anything. I'll name it Kali. Now you have to choose your path where you want to store it. I'll let the default one. Then we have to choose the type. Choose Linux. And in the subtype, choose Debian. And click on next. Here you have to choose what amount of RAM and what amount of CPU you want to give to the virtual machine. So I'll recommend to give at least 4 GB RAM for the virtual machine. And okay, click on next and feel free to choose what amount of space you want to give to the virtual machine disk, and it is totally okay if you go with the default. Click on next, click on finish, and your virtual machine is now not almost ready. Now click on settings, go on general, advanced, and set clipboard to bidirectional and drag and drop to bidirectional. Also in the display section, increase the video memory to the highest, like 120 MB here available to increase to the highest. Here in control IDE, go to the empty and click on this CD device icon and choose a disk file and choose the installer image that we installed. Hit on OK. Click on OK. Okay, sorry, we have to make some other changes. Go to the network and make sure that it is chosen as NAT, and that's it. Click on OK. So now we have configured all the settings as we required. Now let's start the virtual machine by clicking on the start button. So as you can see, our Kali Linux virtual machine is started and it is showing the boot screen to install the Kali Linux machine. So let's install Kali Linux. Okay. So I'll go for the graphic install option. Now choose the language here. I'll choose English, then continue. And here you can choose, I'll let it United States. You have to configure which type of keyboard you are using. Then click on continue. Here you have to choose a host name. I'll let it Kali and click on continue. Then you have to give your domain name. So I also give it name Kali, then click on continue and here you have to type the full name of the user and Kali for the username. Okay, continue. So here you have to type the password. Now click on continue. So here you have to choose the partition of disk, and I will prefer you to go with the use entire disk option. Click on continue. Then choose this hard disk and click on continue. Okay, so and here you have to choose the first option, all files in one partition. Then continue. And here you have to make no changes. And here it is asking whether you want to write the changes to the disk. So you have to choose the option yes, then continue. Now here this is the part of software selection. So I'll recommend you to don't make any changes here. Simply click on continue. Now it is asking whether you want to install the grubs to bootloader. So click on yes and click on continue. And from here choose your drive which is already created and hit on continue. Now click on continue to reboot. So as you can see, our Kali Linux machine is successfully installed in the VirtualBox. And if you want to make it full screen, then you can go to view and hit on the option full screen mode and enter your username and password that you give at the time of installation. So as you can see, our Kali Linux machine is successfully installed in the VirtualBox and it is working fine. There is no fault in it. We can run commands. So that's it for this video. I hope you like this video and I hope you understand how you can create a virtual Kali Linux machine on your laptop using the VirtualBox. So that's it for this video, and if you have any doubt, then let me know in the comment section. I'll try my best to clear the doubt. If you want to see more content like this, then let me know in the comment section.